Hardin County coroner says it wasn't an officer's bullet that took a man's life in a shootout with police.
47-year-old Michael Strand shot himself in the head after police went to question him about a burglary. WLKY's Erica Coghill now joins us with the latest. Erica?
Rick, Vicki, it all happened last night on Seminole Drive just before 6:30 when police and Strand shot at each other. No bystanders were hurt, but a bullet hit and ricocheted off an officer's boot. Police tell us when backup showed up, they went inside Strand's apartment, and that's where they found him dead. Lights flashed through the Foxwood apartment in Radcliff Wednesday night. For 47-year-old Michael Strand, it's where a violent night started and where his life ended when police say he put a bullet in his head. Authorities say an investigation led Radcliff police to Strand's doorstep. They were looking into a burglary Strand's next-door neighbor reported.
To my knowledge, they didn't have any warrants for Mr. Strand. They were just there to talk with him and talk to him about the burglary that occurred.
Police were wondering if he knew or saw anything, but a few questions turned tricky. Police say they asked Strand to go with them to the station, and when he went to get his shoes, he returned with something more dangerous.
And he produced a gun, and as a result of that, gunshots were exchanged.
While authorities say both Strand and officers fired shots, they're still investigating who fired first, but say either way, the gun alone was enough to put them in danger.
Once a gun is produced, you know, I don't necessarily have to wait until shots are fired at me before I return fire.
Neighbors and apartment managers say he was a nice guy. They say he kept to himself most of the time, but when he was out, he helped out around the apartment complex. They also tell us he was a retired soldier who last worked in Fort Knox. Meantime, police investigate what sparked Strand's actions.
Maybe they can determine, you know, if there was something that maybe triggered his actions for police, because like I said, they were just questioning and really had no reason to fire shots.
And as far as those officers involved in the shooting, Radcliff police tell us they're now on routine administrative leave. Erica Coghill, WLKY News.